Hey guys, Stephanie with you today for Club La-La Land Crafts. I'm back with you, as I promised, for some coloring, and I'm also going to show you not one, but four projects using the Make Kit from Club La-La Land Crafts. So I'm going to show you the coloring part, I'm going to speed it up, put some music on, and then I'll catch you back at the 16th minute. And if you want to fast forward and go to the 16th minute, as I said, and I'm going to talk a bit about the projects, and you're going to be all set. And just catch me up soon because we're going to show other projects for this edition. Okay!
Thank you.
Okay guys, so now that the coloring part is done, I'm super excited because I'll get to play with those images that are already colored for my next two projects. But before that, I wanted to show you my first, not one, but I've got four projects to show you today. One of them being the one that you're going to be able to do step by step with the exclusive tutorials at Club La-La Land Crafts. So this first project, that it's absolutely so cute. It looks simple, but yet I think sometimes we need simple stuff that we can do in a whip and then give to our loved ones. So, and let me say this sentiment right. So gnome is where your heart is. So the first project I'm showing you, and then I'm super excited to share because it's super cute and it's not in those red tones that we've been seeing a lot. I wanted to show you something that is all about the grain for gnomes. So I've got gnome is where your heart is, and when you open the card, ta-da! You have your gnome Marcy waiting for you right here. So this is a fun project, and of course on this project I've used not only gnome Marcy, but I also used the little fairy house, the stump, the stump, and also the little berries. Let me tell you that those dyes, especially this month, they cut like butter. I don't have to run them twice through my Gemini Junior. It's just fabulous. So my die cutting machine, whatever you use, is perfect for the Club La-La Land Crafts dies. And what's also fun, let me grab my dies. What's also fun is that, as you can see here, you have the border with the grass and the little mushrooms. And you also have, so let's take the fairy house. So that little fairy house, as you can see, it comes in one piece. But what's cool is that once you die cut it, you have all those little embossed, let me try to zoom in. Yeah, it's kind of difficult. Once you have them, you can see that there are some patterns that are embossed and stitched right into the die cut that you just obtained. And what's cool is that with this one, you can follow the little lines and then easily cut with a pair of sharp scissors, so that you can die cut multiple times on different color of cardstocks, this little house, and then you can glue them on top of each other and create different layers. So that's just super cute, and I've done the same technique with a bunch of other cards that you're going to see. So that's one of the tips that we share with the subscribers at Club La-La Land Crafts. So make sure that if you're not a subscriber yet, make sure to subscribe with the link below, because you won't want to miss next month's edition that we've already seen, and oh my god! So for this project that you can entirely do step by step once you are a subscriber, we also have, and as I promised, I not only did one project but three projects, because when I started coloring these little gnomes, I didn't know which one I wanted to use with this collection of paper. So I said, well, let's just fussy cut them and do three different cards, but that are also kind of similar, so they're matching, I'm sorry, if I can say this. And look at this one. So this one, the sentiment says, you know me so well, and you have the little stump, the log, you have the leaves, you have the grass that I cut. Instead of having the full border, I just took the one for the leaves, and look, oh! So it's like the gnome is having fun and jumping or whatever. So on this card, if you can see, there's a little wobble right under the silhouette of my gnome, and I just find it so cute. So I wanted to make sure that you could see how cute it is. So you know me so well. And then you have this one that says, hello, hello, because I found it cute that the little gnome was waving to somebody. So you, and also again, I did the technique where I layered all the different
parts of the little house. I did the same thing with the mushrooms and then the grass. So it's super, super cute. And then on this last one, I used the negative of... So, as I was saying, so on this one, I took a piece of white cardstock, I die-cut it with this, the nested frame, and then I used the negative part to create the frame of my card. So isn't that cute? And I also have my gnome, I have the grass, the stump, the leaves, the little house, and the sentiment says, for my best gnomie. And you also have the little mushroom that I cut and put right next to the sentiment. So that gives us not one, but three projects with the gnomes, and also one project with Marcy, so I don't know where to place her. Let's just go here. So I hope this gives you an idea of all the possibilities that you can do with the May Club Kit. It's just gorgeous and fun, and I'm going to be back soon on my blog to share two more projects using them with the images that we've just colored in this video. So I hope you are inspired, and that I'll see you soon on Club La-La Land Crafts+4.